grace, mercy, and peace
will be with us
from God the Father and Jesus Christ the Father's Son, in truth and love. Amen. They did not yet understand the scripture. They woke up this morning to news that Jesus' body was not in the tomb. But they did not yet understand the scripture. John and Peter went to see for themselves. They found only the cloths that Jesus was wrapped with. They should have got it. The time was not yet right. Mary Magdalene was confused when she went to the tomb the first time, too. They did not yet understand the scripture. They had seen him do miracles. They heard his teaching. They saw him heal the blind man. Jesus could make him see. It wasn't yet time for them to see the truth. They saw him raise Lazarus from the dead. They could not yet understand what had happened this morning, for they did not yet understand the scripture. He had told them over and over that he would rise on the third day. They heard him give the Pharisees the sign of Jonah, who spent 3 days dead in the belly of a fish, only to be spat up once again. They did not yet understand the scripture. They heard him tell the Pharisees to destroy this temple, and in 3 days he would build it up again. They watched it be destroyed. But they did not yet know that he was talking about his own body, for they did not yet understand the scripture. John and Peter had saw Jesus transfigured before them. They could see his full divine glory. They did not know that that was a precursor to things to come. They did not yet understand the scripture. They heard him speak about a grain of wheat and how it must fall into the ground and die in order to bear much fruit. And so Jesus, as the grain of wheat, did die. But they did not yet understand the scripture. He said that he came into the world as the light, so that no one who believes in him may be left in darkness. He said that he came to save the world. How could he do that while dead? They did not yet understand the scripture. He told them, "A little while, and you will see me no longer, and again a little while, and you will see me." Well, they hadn't seen him for a little while. They did not yet understand the scripture. They knew how the Lord had led the Israelites out of Egypt and saved them from the Egyptians. They knew that Moses had sung the song that we heard in our Old Testament reading. They knew that their God always wins the battle. But they did not yet understand that this scripture applied to Jesus. And then they saw him. He appeared before them. He appeared before Mary. She turned and saw him, saw his face, and knew that it was him. They could see clearly. Jesus taught them. He instructed them in the scripture. The Holy Spirit gave them understanding, and they knew that Christ had returned from the grave to declare victory. They understood that Jesus hadn't been in the tomb because he had risen. They understood that the cloths of death were left behind in the grave. They knew that Lazarus was raised from the dead as a precursor to show that he had power over death. They knew that the sign of Jonah was a sign of resurrection. They knew that Jesus had rebuilt the temple forever. They understood that Jesus had fallen into the ground and died, but he has grown forth and borne much fruit. They understood that Jesus was the light, and that they no longer had to wander in darkness, nor fear that they would fall in the traps of the devil. They understood that that little while had passed. The morning is over. It was worth the wait. Now they could see Jesus. And finally, they understood how the history of Israel was fulfilled. Just as the Lord had brought the Israelites out of Egypt and out of slavery, Jesus had brought them out of bondage to Satan into the promised land of his kingdom. Now they could sing of his victory, similar to Moses did. I will sing to Jesus, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider he has thrown into the sea. Jesus is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. This man is my God, and I will praise him. My father's God, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a man of war. Jesus is his name. Satan's chariots and his demonic host he cast into the sea. His best generals were sunk in the lake of fire. The floods covered them. They went down into the depths like a stone. Your right hand, O Lord, glorious in power. Your right hand, O Jesus, shatters the enemy. In the greatness of your majesty, you overthrow the adversary. You send out your light, and it blinds them who are in the darkness. As Jesus took the wrath of God, the waters piled up. The floods stood up in a heap. Your anger stood still in the heart of the sea. Satan said, I will pursue. I will take his life. I will have victory. My only desire will be fulfilled. I will draw my sword and kill God. You blew with your spirit. The light overcame him. The darkness was dispelled in eternal victory. Who is like you in this world, O Jesus? Who is like you? Majestic in holiness, awesome in glorious deeds, doing wonders. You stretched out your right hand, the earth swallowed them. But by your steadfast love, you have led the people whom you have redeemed. You have guided them by your strength to your holy temple. The demons have heard and they tremble. Terror keeps their lies at bay. Now they are too discouraged to deceive. Satan trembles in fear. All his army shudders at the thought of you and your name, O Jesus. They are horrified, for they know they have lost. Because you have brought light into the darkness, it is as though they are statues. Until your people have passed through your wrath, your people, whom you have bought with the blood of the Lamb, them you will bring onto your holy mountain. Into your presence you lead them. The fortress you have made for them, there Jesus Christ will reign as our King forever and ever. We too have that glorious victory that the Israelites saw at the Red Sea. And it is more glorious. It is better, more complete, and eternal. For through the gift of the Holy Spirit, you have the same understanding as was given to the disciples. You too can rejoice with Mary at the sight of Jesus. And now, unlike Mary, we may cling to him. We may cling to him so that we can make the same journey he did through the grave. As he passes through, going down into the grave, we hold on to him through death and come out on the other side resurrected. One day, those headstones in the cemetery will have outlived their purpose. Hold on, and you too will rise from the grave. Run to your king, and he will defend you. Walk through the waters of Satan, which so desperately wants to kill you, while God holds them at bay to your left and your right. Watch as Jesus uses death, the tool of Satan, and stabs it into his own side to win victory everlasting. The power of death is gone. The power of Satan is vanquished. No darkness remains, only light. No one is better in battle than Jesus Christ, the Lord God of hosts. And finally, all this the disciples knew. For when the time was right, they understood the scripture and passed this knowledge until here today. We too may celebrate the glorious victory of Jesus Christ. So let us celebrate the festival with all the joy we can muster. The time has come. The victory feast is here. In the name of Jesus, our blessed Savior, amen. Please rise. The peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus until life everlasting. Amen.